A crowd of the boys was whipping it up in a Sandy Row saloon as they sung to an old piano that was badly out of tune. The night was July the 11th, and they made the rafters roar with a most harmonious rendition of the sash my father wore. Outside, the brazen bonfires made night as bright as day, and all the crowd was dancing in a wobbly sort of way. There was educated men among them, cultured men, you know, men like Billy Bothwell from the village of Drumbo, a painter by profession, but an artist to his friends. He'd painted many a masterpiece on some Protestant gable ends. And it was poor wee Tommy Ferguson, a prod from Donegal, specially invited and beloved by one and all. A ballad singer was Tommy, and singing still a hope. He was well known throughout Ulster for his songs about the Pope. There was shipyard men and dockers, all with glasses in their hands. There was transport men and fitters, aye, the toughest in the land. And standing there among them and drinking up her fill was a well-known local lady by the name of Orange Lil. But over in the corner, a stranger sat his lone, and no one paid no heed to him as the gaiety went on. Ach, he was a very weary traveller. He tramped for many a mile, and he'd just come in and sat down to rest himself a while. But Orange Lil soon noticed him, as her sort often does. So she went like and sat beside him, and she asked him who he was. Ach, he says, I'm just a very weary traveller, and but a civil one, you'll find. I just come in to hear the crack. I hope the boys don't mind. Well, now, Orange Lil, for all her faults, she's a heart as pure as gold. And she turns round to the fellas and says, look, someday we'll all be old. So get this man a drink or two and make him feel at home. And so they did, and soon the whiskey and the beer began to come. And then someone says to the stranger, come on and sing a song. But the poor old lad says, sorry, but my singing days is done. But I used to play the piano. And so if it's all right, I'd like to play some music in honour of this night. Ach, his coat was all in ribbons, and you should have seen his hat, and his tattered sleeves were flapping on the keyboard as he sat. Ach, everybody pitied him. It was a sorry sight. But I can't help remembering that his eyes was kind of bright. Well, it wasn't very quiet in the pub, I needn't tell, with the clattering of the glasses and the gabbling as well. But as he started to play and the notes rose in the air, a mighty hush descended on the whole assembly there. The shipyard men and dockers, they never made a sound. The transport men and fitters stood rooted to the ground. And as the sweet notes tinkled on, the place was deathly still, and I even seen a tear roll down the face of Orange Lil. Well, as long as I am on this earth, I'll not forget that night. I mind it just like yesterday, a sad and a moving sight. But the saddest bit I've yet to tell, and a tear I know you'll shed, was before that night was over, that poor old man was dead. Now he lies in his earthly grave, away from this world of strife. Above his head a tombstone tells the story of his life. It says, here lies the bravest man who'll be remembered long, because one night in Sandy Row he played the soldier song. Got you there.